name is Eric Strebel. Welcome to another video of mine about industrial design. I needed to create a gasket out of silicone for a project that I was working on. I was talking with the technical manager at Innovative Polymers about the right silicone to use and what might be a good way to go about making these gaskets. He suggested 3D printing the molds. I was able to quickly draw up some plans in Fusion and print out the molds on our Ultimaker 3D printer. And I was able to make a series of molds very quickly. And here you can see me trimming up the parts. You can see how they fit together. They snap inside this race. And then the three layers stack on top of that, and there's a little groove on the inside, and that's where we're going to inject some silicone to make our molds. And that's what the rest of the video is going to be about, this process of casting these gaskets in these 3D printed molds. I used the GI 1040 silicone that I purchased from Innovative Polymers. Now, they don't make the silicone, but they're a distributor for it. I use it for most, if not all, of the mold making that I do. It's really good stuff. It's not that expensive, and it works out really well. Here I'm mixing the appropriate amount of activator. I have a scale. It's all measured out in grams, so I can mix in the right amount. And I mix it up really good, thoroughly. And off it's going to go into the vacuum chamber. Silicone's a pretty thick material, and I would suggest you get a good vacuum setup, a good vacuum tank and a good vacuum pump, so that you can pull the air out of your silicone and degas it properly so that your silicone doesn't have any air bubbles in it, and you get a nice consistent material, whether you're casting molds or you're making parts like this. Now, because the silicone is really thick stuff, I'm not going to be able to just pour it right into those little grooves to create my gaskets, and I need to inject it into that little area. So what I'm doing here is I'm loading the silicone into a syringe so that I can basically inject it into the molds where it needs to go. It allows me to then accurately put the material where it needs to go in the molds with a fair amount of force without it going everywhere. So what I do here is I'm just pushing up the syringe, trying to get the majority of the air out of it, and I'm going to put the syringe back into my vacuum tank, and I'm going to degas it some more to try to take some more air out of the silicone just from pouring it into the syringe, and so that I don't have any air bubbles. Once that's done, you can see me taking the syringe here and basically going around the little form and injecting the silicone into the little gap, and I can see that it's working really well. I do that on all my pieces, and then I put it in my pressure pot. I'm not going to put it under pressure here. My pressure pot happens to have some temperature capabilities, and I need to heat up the silicone so it cures overnight. I pull them out the next morning, and we'll take them apart and see what we got. So there's a little bit of cleanup involved. The excess silicone that didn't go into the actual cavity where the gasket is, we trim that off just to make things a little bit easier and so we can take the mold apart without breaking them. First layer, I use a little dental pick to pull off that first ring. Comes right off because nothing really sticks to silicone except for silicone. The other two rings are going to pop out and we should have a bubble-free gasket that we can use for our project. So this gasket looks pretty good. We're going to put it onto my mock-up part and see how it works. The gasket's intentionally cast a little bit smaller than the actual location where the gasket's going to fit, because it stretches like a little rubber band. We'll try the little cap on the bottom, and it seats really nice. My guess for how thick the gasket needed to be was pretty spot on. So I have a little cap that fits on really nice onto my mock-up. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel below. You can also follow me on Twitter, where I'm tweeting about products on this planet and different projects that I'm working on. You can also go to the Botson website and sign up for the newsletter and get occasional updates about the different projects that I'm working on. Feel free to share this video on your favorite social media site and let your friends know about it. Rock on!